What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to delete player data in Minecraft. If you've ever been a server operator or if you've enabled cheats, you know how much it can help in the world. But if you're looking to revert your personal progress while still continuing in the same map, you might want to look into deleting a character's progression to restart. Doing it requires some prior knowledge about Minecraft's system, since every account has player data files that contain their progress in the world. This is going to be different for both servers and single-player worlds, so let's go over how to do it. Before deleting any player data files for your Minecraft world, you're going to need to find out your account's UUID. This is a set of values that are only unique to your character. Using this is how you'll be able to locate your player data, with it being a bit more challenging to find it for offline servers. For online players, head to the Minecraft UUID website and enter the player's name into the text box. Head over and press the lookup button to the far right, revealing the account's information, and then copy and save the full UUID values for the deletion process later on. Repeat this process until you've finished with all of the players. For offline players, you're going to want to head to the offline UUID generator and then type your player's name in the text box. For multiple usernames, you'll want to put a comma for separation without spaces. Afterwards, select the plain text option near the bottom and click the convert button. And on the new page, copy and save all of these UUIDs for later. Once you've saved all of the desired UUIDs, your next step is to find and delete their corresponding player data files. There's going to be two files with the same UUID that will both have to be deleted for the best results. Before you go any further, keep in mind that once these are deleted, all inventory items, experience points, character positions, and other aspects are reset, so make sure you have a backup saved of your player's data if you want to have it just in case. For player data in servers, head towards your Apex server panel and click FTP file access near the top left, log in, and then find and enter into your world folder. Find and click the player data directory once you're inside of this area, and then once you're there, use your previously saved UUID to search through the files. Once you find them, press the check mark to the left and click delete at the top, and then repeat this process for all of the player files you want to remove from the world. For single player data, open your Minecraft launcher and click installations near the top, and then hover over any profile and press its folder icon, revealing the local files. In the newly opened window, find and enter the saves folder from the list, and once you're there, head towards your single player world folder. This name can be confirmed in-game from the world's menu. After that, find and enter the player data directory in the folder list, and inside of this area, select all of the desired player data files and delete them. Another way progress is stored is sometimes done by your Minecraft plugins on the server. For example, EssentialsX stores this information in a user data folder instead of a player data directory. Other plugins will have different labels for this, so take a look around to see where yours is. Head into the FTP file access and log in, and then after doing this, find and enter the plugins directory. Click on your desired plugin that contains player data files, and depending on the configuration, find a directory labeled user data or something similar. Once you're inside, select all of the player data files and press delete at the top. While attempting to delete player data from your server's world, if you're unable to find its folder or you don't know the name of the world, remember that you can check the world section of the main panel. It should be listed with a default generated or custom label for you to save and use during this process. On rare occasions, you might not be able to find the correct player data file. This is commonly experienced on offline servers, since each account has a different UUID compared to online players. This is amplified by the fact that cracked users can switch their name, meaning that their ID values change and it makes it harder to delete. While finding their UUID, make sure to use all of the correct capitalization to get the correct one. You also need to make sure you're copying the full UUID value and not the trimmed. If you remove some player data files and you notice that the wrong ones were deleted, you'll have to restore them, so make sure you have a backup handy in case anything goes wrong. Deleting player data is a great way to start players and their progress over without deleting the whole world or any buildings inside. Instead of creating a completely new game, you can narrow it down to just plugins and players, giving you more control over how your world is managed. And of course, if this tutorial helped you today, then don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all of our future videos.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.